Thank you all so much for coming. My name's Delisa. I am the writer and director of my show called Selim. And I just want to say a huge thank you to my cast. I don't know why I got them, but I'm so happy that I did. They are literally the best things ever. And I made some new friends, and you guys are going to love them. So thank you so much. This is Selim.
Our anxiety through yoga. No, hanging out with friends.
Thanks.
Well, did you maybe want to do homework or forge your parents' signatures on all of our papers?
For sure. Why don't you come around around 7 during dinner so my mom thinks I have friends?
Deal.
I live over on the house with the yellow shutters. I can't make it.
Okay.
You guys are welcome to stretch if you need it.
Oh,
need your address and number.
Why?
So in case you decide to spill any tea, we know where to find you and kill you.
Fine by me.
Thanks.
Hey, why are you shooting this?
I prefer just to observe and hunt everyone with their secrets.
Finally showed up.
Of course she did.
Saffron.
What? I said we needed her here as in on Earth, not as in the lounge.
Sometimes I really forget. I really think you guys forget that I'm right here. Sometimes. Inches away from you.
Sometimes I think you just forget that you don't know how to shut up.
Why are you such
a- Okay, yoga time. Everyone, kneel to your knee. Now extend your right leg in front of you. Press on both sides.
Oh dear God.
You feel that pain?
Now express it through words.
I had a fight with my best friend.
Cass has a friend?
Shut up, Saffron!
Feels good, doesn't it?
Sure does, Saffron!
My parents want me to be a lawyer, but I don't want to give up dance for that.
I'm infatuated. What's wrong with that?
Despite the fact that you don't really like this person.
I don't want to have feelings.
Because everything and everyone I've ever known leaves me.
We had a best friend. We made the lounge for her, but she thought she'd be happier without us.
Why don't you just talk to her?
Because she's not here anymore. I also lost my dad. He never really liked me much, but he loved Calico. When I came out a few years ago, he declared I wasn't feminine enough and used that as his ammunition to leave me and my mom for his new girlfriend, Monica. She's 19 and he's almost 50. He's literally with someone 2 years older than me.
Oh, so like Scott Disick and Sophia Richie.
Exactly, but in this case, Courtney actually cares.
It really hurts to see my mom so upset all the time. I can't encourage her to get out of the house or do anything. I may be gay, but unlike the stereotype, I'm not fashionable, so I'm not really of much use to anyone.
Okay, I barely know you, and I can already tell that isn't true.
That's not true. We're still here.
Okay, well, who said I love you? And plus, most of the time, I wish Cass wasn't.
Stop it, okay? You're allowed to be hurt and you're allowed to be upset, but what you're not allowed to do is push people away who actually care about you. You care about Cass. You even showed up to her house and gave her a nickname.
At least we got to her to admit that she cares about herself.
Dude, Calico, why are you still doing yoga?
I don't know, it just felt good.
Okay, well, subject change, please.
We still have 15 minutes before class starts. Do you girls want to tell ghost stories?
Why the hell not?
Okay, Cass, we used to do this with our friend. Storytelling and writing is another way to release anxiety and emotions. There's flashlights in the couch, and I'll hit the switch.
Okay, so once I read this book about this girl who went to a summer camp. She didn't quite fit in right away, but soon she met a friend. They did everything together. Every day they talked and they laughed, and one day...
No. It's supposed to be scary, sis.
Well, it was going to be, because soon you find out...
No. I'm turning the lights back on.
Alrighty then.
I don't like spoilers. It has to be raw and have emotion, but also have the possibility of being real. She didn't provide drive, passion, or imagery, and for that reason, it is a no from me.
You just mixed Simon Cowell with the entrepreneurs from Shark Tank.
Sorry, our friend was really good at this. You have a lot to live up to.
If you don't mind me asking, what was she like, and what was her name?
Mind.
She was the best. She always ate bacon and wore the same jacket every day.
And the same black leggings, it never failed. On good days, she'd spice it up with jeans. In other words, when her mom did the washing.
I actually have a friend like that. It's not fun. Continue.
Yeah, she was the best. She always helped everyone else with their problems, and I think that's how she dealt with hers, you know, the distraction. But sometimes it just got too much for her, but I just wish she would have known that the fog would have cleared up.
I'm sorry we're talking about all this.
It's fine. I don't mind. Really, I don't.
Thanks.
Have you ever lost anyone, Cass?
Yeah, but it's not the same, you know? She just doesn't want anything to do with me.
Why don't you just talk to her?
Fine, I will.
Okay, big shot, do it now.
She's not answering the phone.
Of course she's not. Because you don't have any real friends. I'll call again and leave a voicemail.
Hey, Helena.
Whoa! What's her name?
What?
Is this some kind of freaking joke? We open up to you and you think it's funny to pretend to call her? You're not new, you've known this whole time. Now get out!
Wait, no.
On the first day, how did you find us?
Helena showed me. She came in right after me. She did yoga with us. You guys are kidding, right?
Cass, you've always come in here alone.
Stop, this is getting creepy.
Oh, so we're the creepy ones.
Helena, you said? Describe her.
Well, she's super sweet. She's super sarcastic. She wore the same thing every day almost, but she never failed to match her headband
to her scarf.
So what does this mean?
Is this Helena?
Yeah.
Cass, Helena's been dead for 2 years.
She's right there.
We can see her too.